I like the classical kind of look. I just see all these young men being really uptight about how they look. I don't know if it's there's a lot of pressure about looking like a man, but there's certainly a big task, a problem, whatever, in the male body image. People don't know what a man's supposed to look like anymore, and there's no answer to what a man's supposed to look like.
The ideal male body image is as unscripted in the fitness world as it is in the fashion world.
The funny thing is there's not one look today. Even the top models today are not as much men as they used to be, kind of thing. Like, that image has gone out. The David Hasselhoff kind of like really hairy chest and big guys, you know, that's gone away too. It's more a feminine kind of turn to it. Today it goes in all kinds of different directions, you know.
But with all these different looks, there is one thing most can agree on.
Six pack.
Six pack.
The abs.
Six pack.
Six pack.
Six pack.
Definitely six pack.
A six pack.
Good abs.
You know, some people really want those visible abs.
Advertisements play a large role in the public perception of what the ideal man looks like. And this is going in a different direction than the fashion world.
Now we're looking into an era where you want men to be very manly, dark, handsome, muscular, without being too buff. That was his appearance. So you needed to be able to identify yourself with him, but also there needed to be some kind of eye candy for a female audience. And you wanted, of course, guys to be inspired by him and want to just have a little bit of what he has.
Models are given strict guidelines to fit into these ideal looks.
We get told to slim down as well. We get told to, you know, you have to be fit for that stuff. I run a lot, but I used to do a lot of weightlifting and CrossFit and all that stuff, but I can't really do that because I can't fit the suits if my shoulders go too wide, so I can basically pretty much run. But usually it's more healthy with the guys. So if people go to extremes, they just work out really hard, they watch what they eat all the time, that stuff. It's not like they don't eat food for 4 days, you know?
Pressures to fit into one of these ideal looks can lead to extremes like megarexia. An obsession with how the body looks and believing one's muscles are never big enough. Morton was self-diagnosed with megarexia in his early 20s.
I'm gonna sound so pathetic now, but it's honesty. I got bullied a lot when I was little. I was thinking, if I get this big, people will leave me alone. Because that's all I wanted, was just people leaving me alone. Back in the days, when I started training, when I was in my early 20s, I really wanted to get big. And my idols were Stallone and Schwarzenegger and all those idols. They're still good people and good looking compared to the bodybuilders today, who are just freaks. But I wanted to get big, and I was all about the easy solutions, you know? And I started doing steroids, and just when I looked in the mirror, even though I did this, I was just thinking, damn, you look like nothing, you're nothing. And it was so destructive, such a self-destructive pattern all the time, reinforcing it, eating, to the point of nausea all the time. I didn't want to eat, but I just kept stuffing myself like it was foie gras. I was turning myself into foie gras. And it was so unhealthy. And no matter how big I got, my friends were like, you look like an idiot. And they were also, we don't want to hang out with you because we don't know how you're going to respond to this and this. I remember myself just having a mental breakdown in a gas station because I bought a sandwich and it contained almost no protein. It looked really good because they had put all the meat out in front, but that just stopped like a centimeter in, you know? There was nothing in that. I was just like, what the the fuck is this, you know? And I was just looking at myself afterwards and going, are you becoming this guy? You want to be like that? I said, ah, no, this is not for me. I would, on my way home from training, feel like my muscle tissue was breaking down. Like I could feel it breaking down, becoming softer and weaker and looking smaller. And I thought to myself, damn, who are you becoming? How's that for a mental problem?
Megarexia is not considered a disorder by any healthcare system in Europe. There is no official treatment for it.
No one's talking about it. And if no one's talking about it to the therapists or whatever, how can they diagnose it, you know? This is clearly a mental problem. This is a big mental problem with your body image. It's a psychological disorder.
It's a self-controlling, self-destructive pattern. Just permeating anything you do in your daily life, and it's just, it leads to the point of isolation.
Those with megarexia lack an understanding of health. For some models, looking good takes priority over being healthy, and that can give an unrealistic image of what the body should look like.
I've heard stories, of course, that people, you know, if they have to do some underwear stuff, they don't drink water for like 24 hours and that stuff, because then it like drains out and you get more definition and all that stuff. I've seen some really skinny guys, but usually it's just because they live off, you know, McDonald's and cigarettes.
These unhealthy habits would no longer be successful in advertising.
I think it has changed and it will continue changing. And now you just have to look healthy. You don't have to be buff. You don't have to be slim or skinny, but you need to look like you have a healthy life despite all your faults.
But everyone has different views of what healthy looks like.
Big arms.
A bit buff, not too buff.
Not like the buffed type.
Broad shoulders.
Some muscles over.
You don't want to see a non-healthy figure.
Looking healthy doesn't always mean you are healthy.
Being skinny is not a measurement of health. Being like he was an Indian prophet, he's saying being well adjusted to a profoundly sick society is not a measurement of health. You know, being skinny is not healthy. Your blood test has to show if you're healthy or not. There's only truth in those numbers, not in how you look. Genetically, some people respond to strength training, resistance training, by just exploding in tissue size, and some people just don't. Genetics, it's an asshole.
While genetics can control how your body looks, new media can control the way the body image is presented.
Even the pictures aren't from the model, you know, it's all to do with the lighting, it's to do with the Photoshop, the post-production, all that stuff. So sometimes it's not even a real picture of a real person, you know.
The manly man seen in advertising is also represented in the film industry.
Male characters that you use today in movies, they have the same approach. I mean, the guys that are very popular today, Channing Tatum or Gerard Butler, etc., Matthew McConaughey,
Justin Timberlake,
Channing Tatum, Liam Hemsworth,
George Clooney,
Orlando Bloom,
Taylor Lautner.
Definitely Zac Efron.
They are quite manly. We are in the beginning of this man-man era. So I think it would take some time before we have the other movement again. It has never been more diverse than it is today. So there's room and there's space for many types of men.
The ideal male body image will constantly be changing, but it doesn't matter what trend comes next for Morton.
I just want a body that's able to do what I have to do when I have to do it.
In my world.
cause I never heard about him with